Okay, first of all, Jonah, love the movie. It was very, very funny stuff.
Thank you.
And you seem to be of the silk now that when you're out, when you're promoting all these movies and you're doing these movies, you're lucky in the sense that you're promoting quality movies. Is that coming from the Apatow background with just the Apatow stamp of approval that you have a certain regard for certain material?
I don't think it has anything. I think any human being should have high standards for themselves. And
not all do, though. Not all do.
Yeah, I mean, I think I take a lot of pride in my decisions, and I think it's easy once you have a successful movie like Superbad to, you know, take a bunch of paychecks and do a bunch of terrible movies. And I think I've been really careful in my choices to make movies that I think that fans of that movie will really like and that I'll really like, and just be respectful of how lucky I am to be in this situation and not just do a movie because they're paying you or, you know, I'd rather, when I'm like an old grandpa, look back and love all the movies I've made than say I'm super rich and made a bunch of terrible movies, you know?
You've got a strong body of work. But this role is actually, it's a difficult role because you're not just there to get laughs, you're not just a comic relief. You have to push the story forward as well, because it is, you know, essentially it's a road movie. You need to keep things moving along. Is that another difficult aspect of the performance, or was it just more of a challenge?
It was more of a challenge. It was great, though. You know, as an actor, you know, I've only starred in one other movie, so for this to, you know, be something different, and then the next movies I'm doing be really different from any of them, you know, I think that's the greatest thing you can ask for as an actor, is to just play different kind of things and continue challenging yourself. You don't want to be too repetitive and make bad movies.
Like, is that what it is? Is that why you haven't chosen to star in something else, really headline something else, since Superbad? You wanted to make sure it was the right movie.
Yeah, definitely. I took 3 years because I didn't feel anything was, you know, good enough, you know, and not putting down those movies, they just weren't right for me.
And there's something else I noticed about this as well, is that it's probably a bit more physicality involved in terms of the humor than in a lot of your previous movies, where it's more creepy, it's more about the, you know, the one-liners, and there's a lot of that here as well. Mm-hmm. Is that something that you enjoyed, the more physical, kind of really putting your body on the line for the sake of laughs?
I don't know. I think it depends on what story you're telling and what kind of movie you're making. I think everything is sort of circumstantial. All these questions are always funny to me because they're like, do you like doing this? Do you like doing that? But it's really like, it depends what movie you're making.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And what the tone of it is and what kind of character you're playing.
I know for Funny People, which you obviously had out, we spoke to you a few months ago for Dash, you did an awful lot of stand-up. You did, was it 3 or 4 months?
6 months.
6 months of prep. Yeah. And Judd had you in the movie for how long? Was it a minute?
30 seconds.
30 seconds. Yeah. Are you holding a grudge against Judd now? Is that like, you owe me?
No, of course not.
No?
Yeah.
But I know you had Louis C.K., the great Louis C.K., I think, is one of the best comedians working today.
He
went and saw you play one night, did he? Or
yeah,
he
saw
you.
Seth and I perform.
And did he give you any bits of advice? Or?
He just kind of helped me shape some of those jokes, yeah.
And Seth was saying that you saw him before and after as well, and did that help at all with that movie, in terms of the character and stuff in that movie?
What?
Did that help with that movie you saw Louis C.K. perform?
Of course. Louis C.K. is one of the best stand-ups there is, you know? That's a real art form that I'm, you know, I'm not a stand-up comic, and, you know, that's a different art form, and it's something that takes years and years to hone and become good at. I'm sure Louis's been doing it for a long time.
Or something crazy.
Yeah, so, you know, he's brilliant, but that takes time and practice, like anything.
And you've got a movie that just opened in the States there last week as well, Cyrus.
Yeah.
And you've got also 21 Jump Street coming up,
and Moneyball.
And Moneyball as well, with Brad Pitt.
Yeah.
Have you shot all these movies yet, or are you just gearing in to shoot?
Well, Cyrus is done. That's coming out. That came out in the States. And that's more of like in the tone of Little Miss Sunshine or Sideways or Juno.
Independent movie, is it?
Yeah, it's just a, like, you know, very grounded drama, comedy kind of thing. And then Moneyball's a drama that I'm co-starring with Brad Pitt and Philip Seymour Hoffman in. And then 21 Jump Street. We're about to shoot Moneyball when I get back next week. And then 21 Jump Street we're going to shoot early next year.
And what's the tone going to be like in 21 Jump Street? Because people are probably, because you're involved and you've got a strong comedic background, are probably expecting more humor.
It is funny. I mean, it's not a spoof movie. We're not spoofing it. It's going to be a comedy. It's going to be funny. Funny movie that has a lot of really good action in it. We really like the idea of just young-looking cops going back to high school.
Yeah. All right, well, John, I really appreciate you taking the time to speak.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks, man. It's good to see you again.
Take care. Yeah, you too. Thanks,